Okay, hello everybody, it's Flew. We're going to do another Kid Rock song. This one is called Picture. And he actually has done this with different female artists. The one I listened to was Sheryl Crow. That's probably the original one, it looks like to me, or sounds like to me. The chords are simple. We're going to go over those at the end of the lesson. And the reason I say simple is because we've gone through all of these chords before. G, C, D, and E minor. Okay? It is late, so unfortunately I can't play the video like I normally do, which, two things that does, I don't want to wake up the babies that are upstairs and next to me in this apartment, but what it does for me is I don't have the greatest timing, so I might play the song a little too fast or a little too slow when I play it for you on the guitar. So you definitely want to listen to the song and make sure you play it at the right speed. That's always been one of my problems since I don't read music, is coming up at the right speed when I play it. So other than that, let's get started. I'm trying to see if there's any notes. So there is one other thing. I don't have the picking pattern to the soul that they do. I've been trying to work on it, but so far I haven't come up with anything that makes sense to me. If I do come up with it, I'll post another video, or I'll redo this video and add the solo into it. So we're just going to do chords during that part of the song. Also, since it is a song that Sheryl Crow sings part of it, there's one line that she says, "I can't look at you while I'm lying next to him." Since I'm singing it, I'm going to change it to her, but when I post it, I'll post the right words. Okay, so our intro is really just a G chord. To me, it sounds like they're playing about four measures of a G chord, four beats each. But it really isn't that important. You can actually just start going and then start singing the song, so that's really up to you. But the verse is going to be G, C, D, C, G. Okay, so G, C, D, C, G, and you do that twice. So, living my life in a slow hell, different girl every night at the hotel. I ain't seen the sunshine in 3 damn days. Been fueling up on cocaine and a good girl to miss me. Lord, I wonder if I'll ever change my way. Okay, and if you notice, what I'm doing on the G chord when I'm playing it, I'm using the index finger, and of course you're on the fifth string, second fret, hammer back and forth. When I'm on a C chord, I'm doing the ring finger on the 3rd fret 5th string. And you can actually alternate between the middle finger on the 2nd fret 4th string, but that's really up to you. These are just things that I add to the song that nobody tells you to play, how to play it, but in listening to the song, I hear hammer-on. So I'm kind of coming up with my own way to play it. The D chord, I'm kind of lifting the middle finger and putting it back down. On the chorus, it'll be the E minor, and I'm using the ring finger, which would be 2nd fret 4th string. And then the same thing on all the other chords, okay? So the chorus is going to be E minor, G, D, C, G, twice, and that's, you're on that last G chord of the verse. I put your picture away, sat down and cried today. I can't look at you while I'm lying next to her. I put your picture away, sat down and cried. I can't look at you while I'm lying Okay, and that verse and chorus was both sung only by Kid Rock, and I'll post it when I put the annotations up. Verse 2 is sung only by Sheryl Crow, and that's going to be G, C, D, C, G twice again. Okay, and you're on that last G. Called you last night in the hotel. Everyone knows, but they won't tell. But then half-hearted smiles tell me something just ain't right. I've been waiting on you for a long time. Feeling up on heartaches and cheap wine. I ain't heard from you. Okay, chorus 2, I'm calling this, and nobody breaks it down. I just kind of make it up so I can kind of give you a rundown of the song without doing the whole thing in one lump sum. So, chorus 2, E minor, G, B, C, G, twice, and this is also sung by Sheryl Crow only. So, you're on that last G, I put your pictures away. I wonder where you've been. I can't look at you while I'm lying next to her, and she'll say him, of course. I put your picture away. Now this would normally be where they do the picking solo, okay? Since I don't have it, we're going to do a G, C, B, C, G, and this is our solo. Okay, now this is verse 3, I called it anyway. And this is where they alternate. First it's her, and then it's him, etc. Okay, and then sometimes it's both. So I will post it in the annotations when I do the song. For instance, this one is going to say her, and it goes, I saw you yesterday with an old friend, him. It was the same old, have you been? Both. Since you've been gone, my world's been dark and gray. Him again. Reminded me of brighter days. Her. Hope you were coming home to stay. I was headed to church and I was on. Okay, and this is what I'm calling a bridge. It's like one line of a verse, so I call it a bridge. G, C, D, C, G, and it's both of them singing. Thought about you for a long time. Can't seem to get you off my mind. I can't understand why we're living life this way. Okay, and I'm calling this last part of it chorus number 3, and it's both of them singing together, and it's the end of the song. And that's on like this. Again, they're on the last G of the bridge. I found your picture today. I swear I've changed my ways. I just called to say I want you to come back. I found your picture today. I'll change my ways. Sorry. I just called to say I want you to come back home. I just called to say. All right, so I did make some mistakes. Like I said again, the timing may not be 100% right, because that's, like I said, that's my weak part. So you definitely want to listen to it and make sure that you play it at the right speed that's comfortable for you. Other than that, that's it, except for we need to go over the chords. So we're going to do G, C, D, and E minor. G chord is 2nd fret, 5th string, index finger, 3rd fret, 6th string, middle finger, 3rd fret, 2nd string, ring finger, and 3rd fret, 1st string with the pinky. That's going to be our G chord. Okay, we're going to do our C chord, which is 1st fret, 2nd string, index finger, 2nd fret, 4th string, middle finger, and 3rd fret, 5th string with the ring finger. We're going to do our D chord, which is 2nd fret, 3rd string, index finger, 2nd fret, 1st string, middle finger, and 3rd fret, 2nd string with the ring finger. And we're going to do our E minor, which is 2nd fret, 5th string, index finger, and 2nd fret, 4th string, middle finger. And I think that's the way I'm doing it in this song, because we're going from here to a G chord. But again, like I always tell you, you can play it with the other two fingers. And I don't think I left anything out. That's it. You know, guys, I don't get a lot of thumbs up. I mean, I've had, check this out, I've had 80,000 views on my 90-something videos. Out of that 80,000 views, I've got about 150, 160 thumbs up, which with a lot less comments than that. And I probably have maybe 10 thumbs down throughout of that 91 videos that I posted. Okay, so the only way I know if you guys like my videos and want me to continue doing lessons, and remember, sometimes the thumbs down seem to have more fun clicking that button. So next thing you know, you got a video and you see you've got 9 thumbs down, let's say, or 3 thumbs down and 1 thumbs up. You know, when I see that, a lot of times I delete the video and redo it, or I just try to ignore it, because that's kind of telling me that more people don't like the video, so then maybe there's something wrong with it. So I need you guys that like my videos to leave me a comment, or what's more important, because it shows as soon as you look at the video, click the thumbs up button. You know, because I don't really know if I'm wasting your time and my time by posting these lessons or not. All right, take care, everybody. Other than that, have a great night. Thanks.